Welcome back to Let's Play the Darkside Detective. Now going into our fifth case, Loch Mess. Kind of wondering about these bonus files here, if they're just as long as the others. And most people said it took them like 3 or 4 hours to finish, like play the entire thing, but it took me 4 hours for these four. So that's probably because I'm reading aloud the dialogue and they're just playing it by themselves, reading it. It's a lot quicker to read it to yourself. But anyway, Loch Mess. Dooley and his blood wolves are attending a jamboree, but the kids rang me in a panic, saying something fishy was going on. Start. Loch Mess. Really enjoying this. Not what I was expecting. Not sure what I was expecting. It's similar to what I was expecting. Close to it. Campsite. Well, here I am. Camp, what am I doing here? Whatever those kids were calling about. I don't see why Dooley couldn't take care of it. Oh, we've got the stuff loud again. Hold on. Unfortunately, this resets every time. I think it was somewhere around there. Options? Yeah. Hold on, actually. No. Yeah, I had it around here. Okay. We can continue, good. The music, okay. That's okay. Guess I didn't pass a checkpoint. Whatever those kids were calling about, I don't see why Dooley couldn't take care of it. Because Dooley can't take care of anything. Campsite. This is what happens when you let the people vote on a name. The other choices were cabin in the wood knot, tent pegging, and the place where you'll die. So not hard to see how it won out. Can't look at our car this time. We usually look at a jamboree sign. A poorly painted sign says jamboree inside. First here? That's odd, but I'm sure the rest will be along soon. Just settle in and don't think about it ever again. That's actually exactly the kind of sign I expect here. Alright. Enter camp. Really there's nothing else to look at, right? It's been years since I came here. Memories, eh? God, animation. Now we can look at our cop car. It's too quiet when driving by myself. I need to get the radio fixed for when Dooley's not with me. I guess that's the closest thing there is to a nightclub for flies. That's an interesting way of looking at it. The scrawl reads, park your automobiles here, then throw the keys away. You won't need them with the fun we will have at the jamboree. No other motives. Honest. Oh. The rope snapped. I guess I have a sign now. Oh, I took it. A wooden plank. One of those odd jamboree signs. Kill bugs with it? That didn't achieve much. Alright, so we got flyers. The flyer reads, come visit one of Twin Lakes. Twin Lakes. Jamie says, they're not really twins, you know. One of them is adopted. This one says, talk to a Twin Lakes native. Jamie, they said, nobody's going to come all this way to talk to you, but here you are. Yeah, I'm here for other reasons. Oh. So is this... Okay, it is not random like the books were in one of the other episodes. Come see our breathing land. We rose 30 feet above sea level when the mountains last inhaled. Okay. Twin Lakes, home to the largest population of Twin Lakes natives. We started running out of tourist attractions pretty quickly. And finally, come see Twin Lakes Sewer Gator. I admit it, that one I made up. An information booth. Actually, the I is for interloper. I often ask myself, Jamie, do you think people will see this eye and understand that you offer reasons why they are unwelcome in this terrible place? I think it's pretty clear. Okay. Let's talk to Jamie then. Hi there. Welcome to Lake Monster. Get out while you can! What? Why? Why? Because of the Lake Monster, of course. It's our number one attraction. Avoid it at all costs! What are you doing here? Every day I ask myself that self-same question. Jamie, you could have followed your dream, I say. You could be a chef. But then I remind myself that I cannot taste flavors, and I think I made the right choice. You can't taste flavors. What are you doing here? Oh, yes, yes. Me and my flights of fancy. I work at the tourism board, and this is the tourism board. We, it and I, tell people what wonderful things to see and do in Twin Lakes. What to avoid, like this lake, and the rest of the city. Tell me about the camp. Campsite got its name as it was the site of a terrible massacre. It's also the site where those angry spirits were laid to rest. Unconnected, it's also the site where terrible tragedies happen each year. Yeah, I'm sure it's unconnected. And it's where kids go on vacation and do fun Blood Wolf activities. It fills my heart with joy to see them play, and with fear because everything here is so awful. Tell me more about this monster. Oh, huge big fangs it has, or tendrils. Maybe even a big sucker thing. And the wings! Oh, if you saw them, they'd probably be wings. They may be fins, though. Hard to tell at a distance. It stands well over a certain height tall and weighs an amount. You can be sure about that. Have you ever seen it? With my own eyes! Sorry. That was meant to be a question. With my own eyes? No, no, I've not. Has anyone ever seen it? And lived to tell of it? No. How many people is it rumored to have taken? Rumored? Many. Proven? None. Right. A fiend it is. But a wondrous attraction for the region. Each day I'm torn between, Jamie, people need the beast, it brings much business, and Jamie, the monster, it kills. Probably. Okie dokie, goodbye, run and don't look back. Seriously, how did you get this job? I married into a powerful tourism family. Okay. Alright, so, yeah. Campfire. Bloodworth, oh, is Devin from one of the previous episodes. The library one? You're here! Devin, you rang? Blood Alpha Dooley has gone missing. This Blood Wolf Armelia. Wah! Blood Wolf Emily goes sob. Missing? Tell me what happened. Devin, much crying. Emily, questionably authentic wails. Armelia says, we don't know. He was here last night. Then this morning, gone. His bunk wasn't even slept in. Devin says, aliens must have taken him. Emily says, mauled by a bear, I bet. Let's not leap to conclusions. When was the last time you saw him? Armelia says, we had nighttime hot chocolate, then he went to the office to, I don't know, do office-y things? I guess we start there, then. Armelia says, we? I don't do entire cases solo, just convenient sections. Come on, we've got us a Dooley to find. Okay. Who are we bringing, all of them? Balloons. I'm no balloonologist, but I'm pretty sure these shouldn't be slimy. Nice campfire. Did you guys build it yourselves? Emily built it all by herself. Emily says, I didn't build it. I just freed the flame. It's how I got my Fire Whisperer badge. Fire Whisperer badge? Amelia says, Blood Wolves have a lot of very much not scout badges. Best not to ask. Alright. Tense. We need to find Dooley. This place is too tense without him to lighten the mood. Get it? Too tense. Emily says, you know what improves a joke? Explaining it. That was sarcasm. Same with that. Alright, it's the same. Okay, let's talk to different people. Devin first. Sometimes I think the fire is whispering at me to burn things. But then I realize it's just Emily. Snitch. Okay, Armelia. Thanks for coming out. These two are on the verge of a meltdown. Looking for him should calm them. No problem. And Emily. Got any more marshmallows on you, mister? No, but aren't you meant to always be prepared? That's scouts. We're taught to never prepare. Armelia says means we're never ready for anything, but it does wonders for the budget. Alright, would anyone like a wooden plank? Apparently not. If I tried that in the academy, they'd have kicked me out. Okay, so we can go to the rec building. The yard is back where we were. Let's talk to them here. I like your car, Emily says. How fast does it go? Fast enough. You don't know, do you? The kind of cases we investigate don't really call for high-speed chases. Devin? I like police cars, and fire trucks, and ambulances and helicopters, but I don't like planes, except for jets. Good to know. And Armelia. Why did you become a cop? It was the coat, mainly. You don't get the same swish out of a normal coat. These are special issue. So see anything? I'm looking for a friend. I'm flattered. I think you're a nice guy, but my social calendar, it's full. I meant a friend of mine has gone missing. Of course, sure, I knew that. What do they look like? He's similar to me, but about 20% more pixels. Seriously? No, sorry, the monster probably got him. Run before it gets you too! They all laugh when I tell them. Oh, Jamie, they say, you and your monster. And then bam, it takes one of them. Drags them off to its mountainy or watery or maybe even cavernous lair. Does this happen often? It might do. It's crafty. Covers up its tracks by never being seen or heard of or doing anything at all, really. Devious. I can't go back to the other area, so let's go forward. Let's go to the rec building. Let's talk to these guys first. Devin? Sometimes I run around and around and around the building, and I go so fast they move everything into the future. How far into the future? Sometimes 5 whole minutes. And how long does it take you to build up the speed to do that? About 5 minutes. That's pretty impressive, kiddo. Good work. Amelia? This place is empty. Where is everyone? At home, with their families. But isn't this meant to be a jamboree? Oh, all that stuff is fake. It's obvious, isn't it? I guess it is, but then why are you guys here? Us? We like hanging out with Dooley. I hope we find him soon. We will. And Emily. I'm glad there's nobody else around this weekend. All those other kids irritate me with their questions. What's your name? Where are you from? Wait a second, is that my bag? More bugs. Flies really need a better hobby. Right window? A dorm room. Reminds me of summer camp out here as a kid. Left window. There's nothing in here. The window covers the wall. The window covers the wall. They forgot to build the room, Devin says, but already had the window ordered, so... Alright, nothing else to look at. Except for... nothing. We can go forward to the lakeside or go in. We'll go in. Hello? That's gotta keep ringing until we answer it, is it? Let's look around first, Devin. Oh, it keeps ringing even when they talk. How annoying. Paper can be damp because of leaks, extreme humidity, being in a jungle, or getting scared and wetting itself. What? Armelia? Stop trying to burn that flyer, Emily. And Emily. Stupid damp paper. One of these is wet and reads, very real jamboree on this weekend. Dooley's pack should come. They are the best pack and will win the jamboree, which is real. Something smells fishy. It's the flyer. It stinks of fish. We'll answer that in a bit. Alright, outside we got dorms. phone, office, canteen. Really nothing else to look at or do except to answer this. Hello? Jack Turner says, hello? Hello? This is Jack Turner, Devin's father. I just want to check in that the boy is doing okay, not struck too wide-eyed by all that nature, I hope. He's, fine? Barbara Turner says, sorry for calling up. Jack is a worrier. Are you on the other line, Barbara? I'm just making a little call, Barbara. Just checking in on the lad, eh, Barbara? He'll be fine, Jack. There's no need to keep calling. Just leave him to have a good time. Yes, well, no such thing as an overprotective parent now, is there? Yes, there is such a thing. This place is lined to the outside world. Devin says, that's what we Tefalone called you on, detective. Okay. So we got outside, dorms, office. Let's go to the dorms. The Blood Wolves of America doesn't exist. Don't ask questions. Go on about your lives. Not the most welcoming poster. Emily says, you gotta want the wolf. We don't have time for blow-ins. Yeah, let's talk to them. Devin? One of these bunks is full of money. Hmm? I hide my Monopoly earnings in it. Amelia? Is this the boy or the girl dorm? There are no genders in the Blood Wolves. It started as a cost-cutting scheme, but ended up being strangely progressive. Emily? These bunks are all mine, but I let my pack sleep in them. A lone wolf is a weak wolf. Okie dokie. So we got props. A box of dress-up props. Let's dig out some bits and bobs. I got props. A bundle of various costume parts in the kids' sizes. I didn't think that would achieve much. Pillow? Looks like this place hasn't been cleaned since the last time I was here. Crime solving for boys. There's a pack of marshmallows called Uncle Gloopy's Squidgy Delights here. Charming. Emily says, hey, my secret stash. Gimme, gimme, gimme. Nope, they're mine now. I got marshmallows. Sticky cubes of solidified sugar. A big hit with the kids. This won't do. The marshmallows are sticky, but they need to be in paste form for that to work. Oh, we're gonna put them in paste form? If you take any more of my stuff, I'll cut you. I'm not taking that chance. Box of dress-up props, but we've taken all the good stuff. The top one was mine. Dooley was below me. Yes, I have Dooley's old bunk, Emily says. So we can't look at these bunks, just these bunks. Hallway? Alright, so... Alright, so that's it. We're back just out to the hallway. So let's check the office, then. I want to be leaves. I want to believe. I keep telling Dooley to stop buying knockoff posters. Alright, let's talk to the kids again. Devin? Sometimes Blood Alpha Dooley lets us play games with him on the computer. You mean this thing? Or that, I guess this. Fill in police reports is the one we play the most. Oh, I'm sure. It's not a computer, that's an oscilloscope. Okay, Emily. When Blood Alpha Dooley is back, I'm going to convince him to turn Betty into a Robot Wars contender. All opposition will be destroyed. Resistance is futile. Okay, Betty is the oscilloscope. Okay. That's my girl. Amelia, how many Blood Wolves are in Twin Lakes anyway? Well, us four are pack 347, but the numbering starts at 210 and skips every 11th pack, so it's hard to say. What? The hell, man? Why is it skipping 11 packs? Alright, lamp. We got Dooley that as a gift. Amelia says, after Emily smashed the room's light. It had it coming! Alright, so... guitar? There's a sticker saying, the truth is around here somewhere. I'm guessing that this belongs to Dooley. Oscilloscope? This is an odd thing for a holiday camp to have. This is Betty. It's like SETI, but better. Hello, Armelia, Devin, Emily, Detective. Why is it talking and how does it know my name? We did say it was better than SETI. How can I help you today? Oh, we can ask you questions. What can you tell me about where Dooley went? Nothing. If Mr. Dooley wanted you to know his secrets, he'd have given you the password. Password, okay. What are you? How are you talking? I'm Betty. I monitor, gather, and collate signals in the search for extraterrestrial life. Yeah, like SETI. I get it. Ugh, SETI is a moron. I speak 13 languages. I'm a chess master, and I've figured out the meaning of life. The meaning of life? Yes, but Dooley deleted that to make more room for his TV shows. See you soon. That is 78% probable. Only 78%? There are things in the night, Detective. That's reassuring. That statement is 93% likely to be a lie. Okay. So the only thing left to look at here is the computer. So we got this and we got exit. Unless the desk itself, no. It's on and Dooley's logged in. I'm not proud of this, but maybe I can find some clues. Cool, man. Windows 95. There's a file in here called password. Let's see. Okay, so his password is password. Honestly, I don't know why I didn't guess that. My computer, email, browser, and a folder. Okay. My computer. Okay, childhood photo. Those were good times. Don't worry, buddy. I'll find you. This machine is pretty much empty. Email? This looks interesting. Greetings, fellow Blood Wolf. You and your pack, I guess, are invited to the 100% legitimate jamboree at campsite this weekend. You have to come. You must. Nigel, fellow Blood Wolf. No need to look it up. Same, okay. Browser. Seems he was hanging out on his Dooluminati.com forum. There's an open thread. Dear Dooluminati, the government are trying to use my brainwaves to hunt me down so that they can pester me into film work. How can I protect myself? There's this guy who keeps bumping his post and pinging Dooley. All of his posts are signed Nigel, fellow human, for realsies. I'm starting to see a pattern here, but who is Nigel? Clicking on the taskbar. Okay, folder. An empty folder. Alright. Alright. So who is Nigel? Alright, so let's continue on to the canteen. Oh, there's a person here. Let's talk to the kiddos. Devin? I can recite pi to 34 ingredients. Emily? The canteen is the best place to come for knives. Why do you need knives? Are you trying to suggest that at your age you don't know why knives are useful? Wait, what age do you think I am? 100? Armelia? What's the food like out here? Surprisingly good. Agnes may be a grump, but she knows how to microwave anything to perfection. Check out the menu. Stew. Don't ask for specifics. What's that? Chief Agnes, pots. They look brand new. Chief Agnes says, don't need no pots to microwave a meal. Can I take one then? Whatever, I don't need them. Okay, I got a pot. We're gonna cook them the marshmallows, aren't we? Good solid pots from 10 years ago. I can tell because they still have the price stickers on them. That bag was too sticky, so I'll store them in here for now. Pot of marshmallows. I just need to find a way to heat this up. I should leave the rest in case Agnes ever needs them. Not gonna happen. A can of dehydrated eggs. What? You expect me to find a chicken every time I needs to make an omelet? Not dog hot dogs. Seriously, our product contains 0% dog, guaranteed. Not a guarantee I would have thought to be a given. Not a guarantee I would have thought had to be given. Half-baked beans from the Not Thought Through Limited. Bowls. I use those to cut Devin's hair. It's why I wear this cap. Metal cups, a can of Colonel Mustard's poison custard, and a box of Radaway radiation removal powder. No way, we got a Fallout reference, Radaway. This place has it all. Okay, so I got an aquarium here. When I was last here, this was full of plastic fish. That's progress for you. Tubing? Some tubing for cleaning out the tank. I think I could get away with taking a small length. I got tubing for some reason. A tube from the aquarium. This is where Dooley would say, that's so they can breathe underwater. I miss that guy. Anything else to look at? We'll talk to Chef Agnes. What? Have you seen Dooley around? I saw him yesterday. Chased him away from my stew. Would have ruined it. He was adding flavors. Not many people here. And? What's am I? The people police? Sometimes they's here, sometimes they's ain't. But you're here. Oh. Sorry, I didn't know yous was the people police. I thought's not. Why do you work out here? Working with kids suits is my sunny disposition. Whatsoever. Alright, so that's this room. That's this whole building, actually. So at the lakeside. Let's go to the lakeside. There's people. What are they, protesting or something? Let's talk to the kids again. Devin. Blood Alpha Dooley says that government is a shared illusion we all experience from chemicals put into the water. Who puts these chemicals into the water? The government. Amelia? I always wanted to be a water wolf. A water wolf? Like a regular blood wolf, but we also learn how to locate and scuttle submarines. Why would you want to learn that? For when they come. Who? The submarine people, obviously. Ugh. Emily? Water is made out of ice and heat. I'm not sure that's entirely correct. Alright. We've got a gas can. An old gas can. Emily says it's empty because I emptied it. Let me guess. To start a fire? No, I poured it on Devin's head so everyone would think he peed himself. What? I gotta make sure the other packs don't want to poach him from us. I guess we got an empty gas can. It's empty. Armelia says they didn't refill it after the tent's incident. This place is in the pocket of the powerful tent lobby, Emily says. Okay, I've received a siphoning kit. I'm just randomly doing this, guys. I'm pretty sure this is illegal to own. A siphoning kit. Okay, we're gonna take some gas, I'm guessing. Alright, we can go on the boat. Cooler. Barry says, we've enough food to wait this beast out for days. And Larry says, all kept nice and fresh in tinfoil. Okay, so you got Barry and Larry. Holding signs. Here's the moon. Got my eye on you, moon. Up there watching all the night crimes, but saying nothing. Obstruction of justice, that's what that is. I know the moon's not a person. I was only joking with it. Joking with the moon, Amelia says. Yes. Alright. So... Let's talk to Barry. Or Larry. Larry says, are you here to see it too? See what too? You have... Barry says, we've been waiting ages and ages for it to show. Larry says, we're starting to get bored of waiting. Barry says, but we're not going home without seeing a monster. Well, good luck with that. Why are you so eager to see a monster? Barry says, we're 100% of Twin Lakes Cryptozoology Club. Larry says, we're always on the hunt for lake monsters, sewer gators, krakens, and, around winter, yetis. Barry says, people don't know this, but there's a lot of strange things happening in Twin Lakes. Believe you me, I know. Larry says, ha, sorry guy, but the cops don't know anything about what really goes on here. Barry says, yeah, go back to getting kittens out of trees and leave the real detectiving to us. Do you not have something better to be doing? Larry says, nope. Barry says, not a thing. Alright. Larry says, see you soon, unless the monster gets you. So if I talk to him, it's the same thing. Okay, they act as one. Got it. Alright, ahead to the boat. An old boat with no gas and a hole in it. I feel sorry for the chump who needs to repair this. I'm going to be that chump, aren't I? Alright, so we need to get gas from somewhere. Maybe out of our own squad car? I don't see any other... wait. Okay, well I don't know why we want to melt the marshmallows, but we can do that here. Let's melt these mallows down, gang. Oh, I guess to plug the hole? Emily says, melt them to the ground! I receive melty marshmallow gloop. The melted marshmallows are as thick as glue. Alright. So that's what that's for. We can fix that, okay. Siphoning kit to the cop car. Stand back, Emily says. It's time for me to summon up some fire juice. Slurp, slurp. Good work, I guess. Now hand it over. What? Give me the gas can. I should have known you were on their side. Full gas can. Give it back! I'm irresponsible, but not that irresponsible. Pity. So I think now we combine this with the wooden plank, actually. Well, the plank is sticky now. Go team! Sticky plank. A section of very sticky wood. You wanted the gas can here. Just teasing me now. Did they say anything different now? No, not really. Catch some bugs? What the? No, sticky stuff. What? Can I wear the props? No. The props are kid-sized, but I'm not sure what to get them to dress up as. Dress Jamie up. Alright, let's go back to the boat. That's the hole fixed. Now to find some gas. I don't have to look long to find it. Splish, splash, sploosh. That's it filled up. Boat's repaired, but where to take it? I need a lead on where Dooley went. Amelia says, we last saw him in his office. Maybe there are clues there? Alright, now we know that the password is password. We can, do that. It's ringing again. Wait a second. Hello? Jack Turner says, one last thing. You know that the boy can't swim, yes? It's my own fault. I should have taken him to lessons, but all that thrashing of limbs, I feared he'd get crushed. And then there is all that water. So much water. You'd think they'd have invented a way to swim without having to get near treacherous water. The amount of things that live in the water. Dozens. And most of these are sharks. Barbara says, Jack, leave the nice camp people alone and come read a National Geographic with me. I think it's time we tackled some of your issues on marine life. No! The sharks can smell your blood through the pages. Reading is making a pact to be prey. Okay, then. Alright, the password is actually for the oscilloscope. How can I help you, detective? Input password. Fine. What was the signal Dooley found? A 2.4 gigahertz ultra-high frequency radio signal. Essentially the internet. But what? Stop trying to cyber-patronize me, machine. All you had to say was fancy internet. Where did it lead him? Across the lake to the signal source. Which was? I'm afraid I don't know. I didn't go. I have no legs. I need that info. If you won't tell me, I'll have to commandeer it. Whatever that means. I'm afraid I can't let you do that, Dave. Ahem, detective. Devin, Amelia says. Devin says, step aside, mister. Time to put my uppity owl, or uppity AI, badge to use. What? Wait, why do you even have a badge like that? Blood Wolf Secret, sorry. And you don't have a needs to know in case of a needs to know basis badge. Just do whatever you're gonna do. Okay. You search the map for places the signal bounced through. I'll lock them in, and once we've found enough of them, we should have the route Blood Alpha Dooley took. Oh boy, a little mini-game here.